here, Richard Main. We're here at the International Bomber Command Center. Beautiful ceremony today. A little bit cool, but a wonderful ceremony opening the International Bomber Command Center. The memorial is on a ridge on the south edge of Lincoln. And it's just like Vimy Ridge, but this is World War II Bomber Command. Do you see that this memorial could be Canada's Bomber Command type of Vimy Ridge Memorial? Can you give us your comments on that?
Well, absolutely, Carl. I've been lucky enough to go to Vimy, and I was lucky enough to be at the ceremonies today. They're very moving ceremonies. Without a doubt, though, a big part of the RCF is in this memorial. So when you look at it, many Canadians bravely fought during the First World War, but of course they did so under the banner of the Royal Flying Corps. We eventually got our own Air Force in April 1924. I mean, there was proto-Air Forces before that, but the RCF was born in April 1924. When you look at the Second World War, that's coming of age of the RCAF. So as many feel Vimy was a coming of age for Canada and perhaps the Canadian Army, this monument here, with what it means for all the Canadians that served in Bomber Command and did so with distinction, and I would add that 6th Group, the RCF's group, we were the only Dominion to have our very own group. So when you look at it, this was the first time that Canadians were fighting as integrated national RCF units. Right. First one to do so, of course, was number 1 Squadron during the Battle of Britain. But then we had 15 other squadrons that served with Bomber Command throughout the war with great distinction and great honor. And this monument here, as well as many of the names on the panel here, are filled with Canadians, as over 10,000 Canadians died in the cause of bringing democracy to the world again.
Right, and you know what impressed me was not only did the Canadians have their 15 squadrons, and they did such a great job, but one out of every 7 airmen that was in a British squadron was a Canadian. So that's 14% of the rest of the bomber force was Canadian. Now tell us about your father, in a Canadian in the RAF.
Yeah, no, my again, another reason it was very proud for me to be here today. It touched and moved me personally because my father was with 50 Squadron, which was 5 Group. He actually was born in Toronto, Ontario. They moved back over to the UK when he was about 9 years old, and he eventually ended up with the RAF, serving as a tail gunner in a Lancaster. So for me, this was a little bit of a pilgrimage. I remember hearing my father's stories of his time in Bomber Command. He didn't talk about it a lot, but what he did say, it was very hazardous. You know, everybody who served in Bomber Command in whatever capacity should be very proud of what they did. You know, the stories that you get from veterans are quite compelling. We have a wonderful veteran with us today from Canada. Very brave individuals. Hard to believe what they did. So many were lost. You know, it's, sometimes on individual sorties, 2-3% of crews would be lost. I've seen it even as high as 10% at times with really bad raids.
Yeah.
You can only imagine the fear that these individuals had going up in these aircraft, carrying out the raids, and coming home just to have to do it again.
Sure. No, I studied up on the bomber crews and some high losses, and especially like Nuremberg, where we lost 90 plus bombers on one raid. Mm. Just horrendous rates. But the Canadians had a good battle record, and we were part of that main force called Bomber Command. So I think it's a proud day for Canada. And when did you lose your father? How many years ago?
My father died about 8 years ago, so he survived the war. Again, I'm very proud of his achievements, what he did in contribution for the cause. But, you know, I felt a part of my father was here with me today.
How to remember the ages of war, from the beaches of Dunkirk to the knock on the door, when they call to Canadians to take up the sword, young boys turned to soldiers and marched off to war.